Today we are going to perform op amp as a adder and a subtractor. Required apparatus:
IC 741, resistors 1 kilo ohm, 4 resistors, function generator for AC input, regulated power supply for DC input and VCC. Here we are doing two methods, AC and DC, CRO, probes, breadboard and connecting wires. This is the IC 741. Pin diagram of IC 741. Pin 2 is connected to inverting pin and pin 3 is connected to non-inverting pin. Pin 6 is connected to output pin. Pin 4 and pin 7 plus minus VCC and plus VCC. This is the pin diagram of IC741. Adder. This is the inverting summing amplifier, so that non-inverting pin is grounded. Here we are giving input to the inverting pin. We can give number of inputs, but here we are giving only two inputs, V1 and V2. This is the RF resistor, feedback resistor. Value is 1 kilo ohm. Here we are taking the output at a 6th pin using multimeter. This is the IC741. We can count it. We can recognize pins 1 to 8 in the shape of alphabet letter U. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Coming to the practical, you can place the IC like this. You can place the grounded. This is the ground line. And take the two inputs from inverting pin. So this is the first input using 1 kilo resistor, and this is the second input resistor. And feedback resistor is pin 2 to pin 6. So this is the circuit diagram. So here we are giving the input through DRPS. V1 is 5 volts nearly, and V2 is 2.8 volts. So we will get the output approximately 7.5 volts. So first input 4.7 volts. And ground goes to the circuit ground. And second input 2.8 volts. This is the ground. So now connect the plus VCC and minus VCC. So this is the plus VCC. Plus VCC at 7th pin. And minus VCC at 4th pin. Now we can check the output at 6th pin using multimeter. So output at 6th pin. So output is minus 7.83 volts. So output is 7.8 volts. So now input V1 is 3 volts and V2 is 7 volts. So now we will get the output is nearly 10 volts. Output is nearly 10 volts. 3 volts. V1 is 3 volts. V2 is 7.2 volts. So output is nearly 10.2 volts. By making small changes, we can made by changing this V2 connected to non-inverting pin, make this into subtractor. This is the circuit diagram of subtractor. Here we are giving two inputs. This is the V1 and this is the V2. And from non-inverting pin, we are giving one resistor to the ground. This is the feedback resistor. We are taking output at 6th pin using multimeter. So by changing the pin to by changing only V2, we can as a subtractor. So this is the subtractor. So V1 is 3 volts, V2 is 7 volts. So the difference between V1 and V2 is nearly 4 volts. V1 is 7 volts, V2 is 3 volts. Vout is nearly 4 volts. Vout is nearly 4 volts. So now V2 is 4 volts and V1 is 10 volts. Okay. V1 is 10 volts and V2 is 4 volts. Output is nearly 6 volts. So this is the subtractor. Still now we have observed DC as input. Now AC as input for the adder circuit. For the adder circuit, V1 is 4 volts and V2 is 6 volts with the frequency 5 kHz. This is the input. So now connect the circuit on the breadboard. So V1 first, ground goes to the circuit ground. V2, V2 ground. We are taking the output at 6th pin. We are observing the output on CRO. So we will get the output approximately 10 volts. Approximately we are getting the output 10 10 volts peak to peak. VT is 4 volts. Now we are getting output approximately 10 volts. V1 is 2 volts peak to peak and V2 is 4 volts peak to peak. So now we will get the output approximately 6 volts peak to peak. 6 volts peak to peak. This is the output of adder circuit. V2 is 4 volts. Output is approximately 6 volts. Subtractor. Now coming to the subtractor. V1 is 4 volts. V2 is 2 volts. We will get the output approximately 2 volts. So output is 2 volts. Output is 2 volts. We can take the another reading. So V1 is 6 volts peak to peak and V2 is 2 volts peak to peak. So now we will get the output approximately 4 volts. V1 is 6 volts, V2 is 2 volts. Output is 4 volts approximately. Thank you.